ஷார்ட்ஹேண்ட் டிக்டேஷன் ஏபி நவம்பர் 1965 80 வேர்ட்ஸ் பர் மினிட் 7 மினிட்ஸ் 10 மினிட்ஸ் ஸ்பீட் 5 செகண்ட்ஸ் நவ் ரைட் டவுன் தி போஸ்ட்மேன் ஈஸ் ஏ ஃபெமிலியர் ஃபிகர் இன் அவர் லைஃப் வி ரிகக்னைஸ் him at a glance. He wears a khaki coat and a turban or cap of the same color, a leather bag full of letters and other papers hangs from his shoulders. In his hands he carries a bundle of letters which he has sorted and arranged for quick delivery. Sometimes his load is heavy. He has to carry a number of parcels, both small and big. The postman is smart and quick in his movements. Time at his disposal is limited. Twice a day he collects the mail of his area at the head post office. Then along with other postmen he gets into the mail motor bus which drops him at a convenient spot near the area in his charge. Now he quickly goes from door to door, gently knocking or calling out to deliver the post. He does not wait for his knock or call to be answered. He quickly slips the letters through the half open door or window or puts them in the letterbox which some people fix to their gates. If there is a registered letter or parcel, a money order or unpaid letter, he has to wait till the addressee comes, signs the receipt form and takes personal delivery of the article. In order to finish the business quickly, he has a pen in his pocket. The work of the postman is very hard in summer and rainy season. From early morning till midday and then for a few hours in the afternoon, he has to walk in heat or rain delivering the post. In summer, it is a pitiable sight to watch him perspiring and covered with dust doing his work unmindful of the heat of the sun. In rainy season, his work is sometimes held up. When it begins to rain heavily, but as soon as the rain stops, he resumes his work. Few of us fully realize the importance of the postman in our life. But if we think for a moment, we find that life without him would be difficult. He is an essential link between us and the rest of the world. He brings news from our relations, friends, and other dear ones. We anxiously await the post every morning and evening. Our disappointment is great if there are no letters for us on a particular day. The postman brings us good and bad news often when he delivers a long expected letter of joyful news. We are thankful to him and give him some reward. But if he brings sad news, we are not angry with him, for he cannot help it. Postmen are very intelligent in understanding whether a letter conveys good or bad news. If he has to hand over a postcard with one of its corners torn, he does it quietly with a serious look on the face. Sometimes the delivery of such a letter is accompanied with a word of sympathy and consolation. A village postman is even a more important and interesting person. He is almost a friend and a companion of the villagers whose post he brings. As our villagers are mostly illiterate, he not only delivers their letters but also reads them out and writes replies for them. For these additional services, he gets small tips in cash. Madras, 1st November 1965, Messrs. Perry and Co., Secunderabad. Dear Sirs, we confirm the following telegram sent to you just now. Delivery will be made tomorrow. We are really sorry for the delay. We have done our utmost to expedite delivery, but the pressure of orders for good blankets from our own state has made it difficult for us to deliver as promptly as we wish, and this is so even when our mills are working day and night. As a result of the sudden change of weather, we know you require the goods at once. We have, in order to show you that we are anxious not to cause you inconvenience, put aside whether other orders, which in fact should have been executed before yours. Our customers are pressing on all sides for immediate delivery, and the demand is heavy. We are not only manufacturers of blankets whose resources are overtaxed at present. We are confident that this explanation will convince you of our endeavor to meet your wishes, and because until this recent rush, we have never failed to execute your orders within the stipulated time, we rely upon your leniency in the present case. We need hardly mention that your orders will always receive our most careful and prompt attention. We request you to remit the amounts due up to date by a draft on the Reserve Bank of India, Madras, at your earliest convenience. Yours truly, Binny Mills.